Hip-hop started from the slums of the Bronx, New York. I fell in love with breakbeats, the techniques, b-boying, MCing, crushing whoever was in front of you. It was groovy. You knew how it was. It's true, it's hip-hop. It's only one source to get it. It's I Do It For Hip-Hop Podcast. Subscribe, Google Play, iTunes, and DJ Bugsy215 SoundCloud. It's all about the hip-hop. Keep it hip-hop. It's Do It For Hip Hop Podcast. It's your boy DJ Bugsy, and I gotta start the podcast off to rest in peace to Malik B. He passed away, 47 years old, original member of the Roots crew. Shout out to Black Thought, Quest Love, and everybody. Welcome home to Jewel Santana, and welcome home Loon. That's how we keep it hip hop. But I got my indie artist spotlight. I got my man Juanny Makk in the building. He got a project out called Wolf, and we gonna get right into that. So welcome to Do It For Hip Hop Podcast, bro.
Hey, how you doing? Thank you. Thank you for definitely inviting me. I definitely appreciate the opportunity.
Well, man, shout out to your queen, because your queen seen a podcast on social media. She reached out. She booked it, and here we are.
Yeah, here we are.
And happy belated birthday to you. Yeah, and I want to give a big shout out to my daughter, Zoe Brianna. She just had an 18-year birthday, and shout out to her. She turned 18. I'm getting old, y'all, so you know.
Yeah, definitely like that.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to my queen, Zoe Brianna Press. I love you. So, all right. So, I want to go back. This is what I always do. I like to go on, you know, time warp and kind of like go back to when you got the pen or who inspired you to want to be a rapper. So, take me back to your humble beginnings. Take me back to the beginning when you picked up a pen. And also, I want to talk about that song on your project Wolf. But we gonna get into that next. But tell me how it all started for you from the beginning.
From the beginning, it was when I was 7 years old, and okay. I'm 29. It's kind of old, you know what I'm saying? I'm 29, but back in that time, you know, we still rocking cassette tapes and all that.
Yeah, absolutely.
So my mom got me and my brother karaoke machines for that Christmas when I was 7 years old, and the karaoke machine had blank cassette tapes with it.
Okay.
So me and my brother would like be up all night trying to record on the cassette tapes, and you know it's not like the studio, you can't punch in, so
no,
you had to like
get your whole thing
straight right all the way through. And it was like we stayed up for hours and hours, days and days, and it was like it just made me fall in love with it, like everything about music. My sister was a big music head, still is. Okay. She had every CD ever made, cassette tape ever made. She got a book with all of them, with the covers, and we used to steal her CDs.
I was just about to ask you, was you stealing it?
Yeah, we stealing them heavy.
Okay.
We was just robbers. We was stealing them joints heavy. All we did is listen to all different music all day, every day. Okay. I got a music quote for almost everything that happened in my life.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow, that's dope. I got quotes, but I don't know if I can keep up with your quotes.
Yeah.
But what I would say is I love the project, but my favorite song on the project is Prayers, and you talk about your brother.
Yeah.
Take me back to that space, even though it was a dark time. Tell me about, you know, your brother passing and how and what it did for you, and did it motivate you? I'm sure it did. But tell me about that.
Prayers, it wasn't just about with my brother, it was just like all the things that was happening around that time, because he wasn't the only person that passed away within gun violence from that time.
Okay.
So it was like it was everything wrapped in one, and like losing him was a big, big chunk, because he loved music, and he like couldn't nobody tell him that I wasn't the one. Like he pushed me. Like I got videos. There's a video on YouTube of me rapping, like in a we did a contest at a bar. We was rapping.
Okay.
And like the whole time I'm rapping, you could see him next to me cheesing, just nodding his head the whole time. Like you couldn't tell nobody that I wasn't. Nobody could tell him I wasn't the one. So it put me in a real, real dark place, and it kind of had me lost. So After a while, I started to build myself on what I feel as though he would have wanted me to do.
Okay.
And it definitely pushed me and made me go way harder. And I definitely accelerated to a whole nother level.
Right. Dang, so, man. That's crazy, man.
Yeah.
Because I see you talk a little bit about people being misguided. You share that a lot on your social media about misguided souls and minds. Can you talk about what you think helps you stay from that space of being misguided, and what would you say to the youth to help them not be misguided?
I would hate to throw shots, you know what I'm saying? I hate to throw shots, but it's really come from my relationship with my father.
Okay.
My father was there financially, but he wasn't there mentally or emotionally.
Okay.
So he left us in a bad space. Mm-hmm. He left me and my brothers in a bad space where
right.
we had to fend for self and try to figure out how to be a man on our own.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, anybody who's somebody, especially if you're from where we come from,
right.
you know that's a bad job.
Yeah. Like, yeah.
Trying to guide yourself as a boy, and then it made it worse on my brothers trying to like be men, learn how to be men themselves, and still try and teach me.
Right.
So it just put me in a bad spot, like a bad place. Like, yeah. And it's like, that's where the misguide come from.
Okay.
You never figure out what it really is to go from a boy to a man, because a man never teaches it to you. So you do all of these things and make all of these decisions thinking that you're being a man, but for real, you're making immature decisions that's going to land you in bad places.
Okay.
So having a son now, my son 2 years old. And,
oh, wow.
Raising my son. Mm-hmm. It just make me want to do everything my father didn't do and capitalize and right. do even better on all the things he did do.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what it really is for me. I would tell everybody to like, don't listen to what other people tell you, and don't try to do what other people do.
Okay.
Like, find the things that you know that's right. Take all the bad energies and put them in a positive.
Mm-hmm.
Take all the bad things that happen to you and put it in a positive. Take all that energy and put it in something that you can do that's going to make you prosper. And not things in the street. Like, don't get mad and get a gun, and don't get mad and get drugs and try to hustle and all. Don't get mad and do things that's gonna make it worse. Cause
right.
that's all they do.
That's
them decisions
true.
Just make it worse. And I tell all the young boys that know me mm-hmm. for real, that I talk to on a regular basis, they know I ain't telling you this because this is what I want you to hear. I tell them that because from experience.
From your experience.
Yeah, from my experience, because that's what I did, and that's what me and my brothers did. And one dead, one in jail. Doing 35 to 70 years.
Oh, so your other brother's in jail doing 35
yeah,
to 70?
35 to 70 for a body. He been down 10 years now. He been down since 2010. So, his kids.
Man, shit, yeah. It's crazy, bro.
He got to watch his kids grow up from a cell. You know what I'm saying? So.
Right. One bad decision can cause you everything.
One bad decision can cause you everything. And that's what I would tell him. Like, make sure you really analyze that decision, because right. one thing can.
Can just. Take
just
it away.
Like that, take like it all that. Away. Especially when, especially these young boys who got it popping. I ran across a couple young boys in the city who got it popping right now. And
right.
they be running around with the wrong groups, making the wrong decisions. I don't be trying to tell people what to do, but
right.
you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You just need to realize that one decision can change all of that.
That's Shoot. True.
If you don't believe it, look at Bobby Shmurda. I mean, he had all that going for him. One
right.
bad decision.
Yeah.
Said the wrong things in the song, and next thing you know, all is taken away. Label dropping him. Doing all this time in jail. I mean, you idolize as a real nigga after that, but what do you have for real? Come home to nothing. You gotta start all over.
Man, listen, you gotta talk to him, bro. You kicking game right now, man.
This is real rap.
You kicking game right now, man. Like,
yeah, this is real rap, man.
Like, straight up, you kicking game. But I wanna know from you, what was the final thing for you that said, you know what? I'm done. Like, what was the final straw? You know how you have that breaking point where you say, you know, I definitely can, because I feel like if I do one more thing, that's going to be it for me.
I had a lot of breaking points that I was naive to. Like, I mean, I got shot when I was 13 years old.
You got shot when you was 13?
Yeah, when I was 13 years old, I got shot. And the bullet's still in me to this day. It's lodged in my hip. I got shot in my back. Bullet lodged in my hip.
Was you at the wrong place at the wrong time?
Yeah, wrong place at the wrong time.
Oh, I was about to say.
It was
about
a crowd of like 150 people, and a guy shot into the whole crowd. He shot into the whole crowd, and it's me and other
right.
people got shot.
Yeah.
So like, that was a breaking point, but I ain't paid no mind. I was naive to it. I got charged as an adult for an armed robbery that I didn't do when I was 15. So, and I went to state road. So, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, I end up beating the case again, up getting thrown out and all that, but it's just going through the whole process. Yeah, I'm in high school.
Right.
I mean, so I sat 7 months on house arrest fighting that case. You know what I'm saying?
As a teenager,
15 years old.
That got to be traumatizing, man.
Yeah, so, but for real, I would say the breaking point for me was when I had my son.
Okay.
When my baby mom had my son, and I held him in my arms for the first time, it's just something just told me, like,
right.
it's over.
Yeah.
Like, you can't do this no more, because you don't want your karma to come on him. So
makes sense.
And then not even just come on him, but I don't want my karma to come on me and him have to live without me, because I seen what being without a father is like already.
Okay. So do you and your father have a relationship now, or it still never was sealed?
It still never was sealed. I tried to like make it right, but you know, some people is to the point of no return. Can't okay. bring them back. Sometimes you just gotta go forward without them.
Okay, but did you ever make a song about your dad? Because I felt like that's what artists do. They tell these stories.
I wrote a whole song about him, right? And then I never laid it. Never
you didn't?
Mm-mm.
Why?
I don't know. I got to a point where
it's
I wanted
deep?
To. Yeah, it's real deep actually. Like I go all the way in on him. Like, but I don't know. I'm the type person that I'm very private. Like, I'm open with my artistry, but I'm very private about my life, because I feel like the more people know about you, the worse off you is, because they use it against you.
Yeah, but what about the people that you can inspire by telling them a story? So it's like a catch-22.
It's like a yin and yang.
Yeah.
It's like a yin and yang.
Yeah.
So maybe I will record it one day when looking at
it. I would like to
aspect.
Hear it, man, because speaking of fathers, my dad was... I had issues with my father growing up. You know, rest in peace to my pop. He died. He passed away, actually. But I was able to mend that relationship before he passed away. And mm-hmm. I think that's tough now that your dad is still alive. But if he passed away, it's going to eat you up. You might. I know for me, certain things that happened with my dad that I wish I could have been a part of, but I wasn't, ate me up. And once he died, it's just like, all right, but I was able to mend it. But I still felt some type of way, because we didn't get a chance to expend as much time as I really wanted to with him. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I understand that. But my thing with me is mm-hmm. my situation different.
Okay.
I did everything I could to try to...
To try to mend it.
Mend that. I mean, I did everything I could to try to spend time, to try to make it right. I even told him, like, it's things... For real, it's things that he done that mm-hmm. I can't forgive.
Okay.
Like,
that you can't forgive.
That I can't forgive. And even though I know that those things was things that shouldn't have been forgiven, I still was willing to mm-hmm. forgive him and
right.
still make it right.
Right.
Like,
right.
all right, I can understand that's happened and this mm-hmm. happened, but like,
right.
let's go forward together. Let's make
right.
it right and do
right.
it together.
Yeah.
But mm-hmm. when I tried to do that, his mm-hmm. image of me telling him that was, oh, you acting like I owe you something. So,
okay.
Well, you don't owe me nothing. I mean, maybe I was wrong.
Right. Now, do you feel like your queen keep you balanced as well?
She keep me heavily balanced, because I ain't gonna lie, man. Like,
yeah.
The way I used to be is, it ain't good. It's not a good person, and she definitely keep me away from that old person.
Okay.
You know what I mean? She definitely keep me away from that old person. And then, but it's like we the same sign, so we both got
what's
that.
What's your sign?
Leo. We both Leos.
Oh God! When her birthday?
Her birthday the 26th of July.
Oh shit! Damn.
Yeah, mine's the first of August.
July Leo and the August Leo.
Yeah, so our birthday's like.
So do y'all clash? Cause y'all both lions.
I mean,
yo.
We clash, but I'm more so the level headed one, so I keep it down.
She the upper one?
Yeah.
Would she get hot quick?
Hot quick. She look, we was just talking about it earlier. We in traffic. She'd throw the car in park in traffic and hop out.
He said hot quick, yo.
Hot quick.
Yo.
Road rage. She'd pull over and throw the park car in park in traffic and hop out and try to fight people and all that. I gotta grab her and let her know, like, yo, like,
yo.
We can't yo. Do that. We in the middle of in a boulevard. We in the
hot
middle
quick.
Of
quick. Oh, I have to call a hot quick. That's the new
hot quick, man.
Yeah. 0 to 1,000?
1,020.
He added a 20 on it.
Yes.
Yo, he added a dub on it.
Yes.
So let me ask you this, bro. With everything that's going on with the quarantine and COVID, how has that affected you personally and professionally?
It hasn't affected me at all in none of those ways. I got my own studio. My house is under construction right now. I'm just ordering like all the new stuff for it.
Mm-hmm.
So it don't really. And music is an everyday thing for me. So
okay.
I write music every day. So it hasn't altered me at all. What has really altered me is what's been going on with like police and police brutality and what they be doing to us.
Mm-hmm. Okay, talk about that. Cause you have a real strong stance on social media about
yeah,
that.
Yeah, yeah. I have a real good like connection with a lot of people in that aspect because I dealt with a lot of that in my life. Like, I mean, 2nd and 15th District, me and my mom lived up there in the Northeast.
Okay.
At a point in time in my life, I had a time where I got in scuffles with cops. I mean, cops beat me up, took me to an alley, took me to a parking lot, ShopRite parking lot, like 1:30 in the morning, beat me up, left me there. You know what I'm saying? Bro. I had a cop pull me over at 66 in Ogontz while mm-hmm. I was going to the barbershop getting my hair cut.
Right.
He walked up to the car with his gun out. Like, he walked up to the car, I look out the window, he got the gun in my face already. He asked me why I was nervous, and I told him, like, right. why? I'm like, man, like, you got your gun out.
Yeah.
It's just a routine traffic stop.
Right.
You got your gun in my face already, you know what I'm saying? Like, y'all be killing people. Like,
right.
That's why I'm nervous. He like, yeah, you exactly right. I took this job because we get to kill people and get away with it.
That's what he said?
That's exactly what he said to me.
Wow, so like, bro.
I dealt with a lot of this stuff personally. That's why it affected me so personally, probably, I guess.
But some, all right, so what you think about white people saying Black Lives Matter and they're trying to help now compared to when Trayvon Martin got killed? It wasn't as big, but now you see people walking in solidarity with everybody all together. How do you feel about that?
I respect it, honestly. Like, okay. I respect it because it just shows acknowledgement.
Okay.
I mean, ain't nobody gonna, the problem, like, speaking of that song I wrote about my father, one of the bars I said in that song is, the problem just gonna pile if you continue in denial. You know what I'm saying? And that's like just what that. It is.
Right.
They not continuing denying it.
Okay.
They starting to acknowledge that what's going on and they becoming a part of the solution and not being a part of the problem. So I think that's a good thing, for real, because,
right.
I mean, it ain't going to work if everybody ain't together. And when I say everybody, I mean everybody.
Right.
It's not just us.
Right. Why do you think George Floyd deaths had such a major impact compared to the other ones like Sandra Bland, Freddie Gray? Why do you think that people across the world, because now this is a global thing, this is not just United States?
Honestly,
mm-hmm.
I couldn't even give you a full answer to that. Like, I don't know. Because to me, in my opinion, it's just my opinion, I feel like they all the same.
Okay.
Anybody who got killed unjust is unjust.
Right.
I feel like George Floyd murder was just like Trayvon's, just like Sandra Bland's, just like everybody who lost, just like Breonna Taylor.
Yeah.
Just like everybody who lost their life.
Okay.
Unjust.
Unjust.
That's just how I feel about it. I don't know if anybody else see his is different.
Okay.
But I feel like that was, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I feel like people probably look at it as it's different because I don't know if people know, but George Floyd and that cop who murdered him is had a personal relationship. They worked together and he's seen George Floyd with a white woman before and they had words before. So I feel like he literally used his job to solve his beef and get away with it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So maybe that can make it different, but I ain't sure because to me it's all the same.
Okay. Now, in the foreseeable future, we know we're going to get a verdict. What do you think the outcome would be, guilty or not guilty? And if it's not guilty, what you think will happen to the United States of America?
Honestly,
as we know it,
knowing the country, it's unpredictable. You don't know what they're going to say.
Because
people knew for sure that Breonna Taylor killers would go to jail, and they didn't. People knew for sure. After hearing everything that happened with Trayvon Martin story, I knew for sure Zimmerman was going to jail.
Okay.
But like after seeing that, it's like, what?
Yeah.
Like he got told, the cops told him not to pursue him and nothing. He still followed him anyway and killed him.
Mm-hmm.
And he still got away. So nowadays you never know. And like I tell everybody a lot of people ask me that. Like a lot of people has asked me that in the last couple months. And my answer would be, is either going to get real good or real bad.
Okay. Yeah, that's true. Now let's talk a little bit about hip hop. Have you been keeping up with the Versus battle? Did you watch the 2 Chainz and Rick Ross battle?
My girlfriend be on me. She be on me about that, man. I don't watch none of them Versus battles.
Why,
honestly,
bro? That's the culture, bro.
But I'm an old school. Like, I ain't gonna say I'm an old school, but I'm a 2090s type of boy. So I listen to that music 24/7. I don't listen to none of the new stuff now, for real.
But I don't really consider Rick Ross a new artist. He's been in the game over 10 years.
But I'm not a Rick Ross fan.
Why not?
I don't know. I like artists.
You like 2 Chainz?
I don't like 2 Chainz that much neither.
Well, who you like?
I like J. Cole, Kendrick.
Oh, yeah, more conscious.
Yeah, J. Cole, Kendrick, Drake, Big Sean.
Okay.
I mean, Joyner Lucas.
Okay.
I mean, I'm more so that type.
Do you think Joyner Lucas has got one of the best albums of 2020?
Nah.
No? Why not?
It's good. I just don't.
You ain't feel it?
Yeah, I felt it, but.
But you ain't feel it, Philly.
Yeah. I feel like Joyner just need to do him instead of trying to, like, follow the wave. I feel like everybody tried on, like,
but I ain't see no wave on his album, cause he did a song dedicated to people with ADHD.
Yeah,
he dedicated a song to Will Smith.
Oh,
I love
that.
That's one of the best songs on the album.
Yeah, I love that. I love those two songs you just mentioned.
Okay,
I love both of them. And Revenge is my favorite song on there.
And he did a song with Chris Brown that was pretty dope
too. Yeah, I love that one too. That one with Chris Brown, that was a great one.
But you just think he. What about Wale? Cause he was in that class.
Yeah, I love Wale as well. Okay. Yeah, I love Wale as well.
Okay.
So.
All right. So those rappers influenced you? Them nuns you named or not really? Who from Philly influenced you? Cause you are from Philly.
It's crazy, right? All right, from Philly, you would be surprised, but from Philly, Oskino.
Shout out to Oskino, man.
Yeah, shout out to Oskino, cause he definitely influenced me a lot.
Really? So yeah, when you used to watch State Property, you was more focused on Oskino
than anybody.
Then Beanie, Freeway, Young
than
Chris.
Anybody. Chris too. Chris and Oskino was.
That was the ones
that
for
was
you.
It. And I like Neef. I listened to a couple of Neef Jones and GIFI had me in the bag.
Bro.
You know what I'm saying? GIFI.
Shout out to Neef Buck.
Yeah, Neef and Chris and Pooter.
And Pooter Brown. Yeah, shout out Pooter to Pooter Brown. Yeah.
They had me in my bag. Yeah, them GIFI projects was everything.
Yeah,
like I banged them Jones for summers.
Yeah.
But Chris and Oskino was my focal point with them.
Okay.
And Petey.
Yeah, Petey don't get the love he deserved, man.
Yeah, he
wanted
all.
He one of the best flow rappers ever, man. Like seriously, on some
and not to mention
to
behind the scenes, he kept them together for real, man. A lot of the
feuds
and all that, he kept them together.
So did you feud with anybody that you came up with and how did that work out for you?
Man. Yeah, I feuded with almost everybody I came up with.
Really?
Yeah.
Was it your fault?
I mean, it's both yin and yang, me and theirs.
Okay.
And a lot of times it was me. My problem was letting people get away with too much. I was helping everybody too much.
Okay.
And letting them do things that was making me uncomfortable and not speaking on it. That was really my problem so much.
Oh, okay.
I feel like I should have spoke up sooner and the problems wouldn't
have infested.
Yeah.
Okay. You got any bars in you tonight?
I mean, I definitely can.
All right, put the headphones on. I want to see you spit something, bro. I got. Man. Now, when this beat came out, I don't even know. You could have been born, but I'm taking it back to the 80s, bro. I'm taking it back to the 80s because that's one of my favorite eras, by the way. You know, shout out to the 80s, Rakim, Kool G Rap. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
EPMD. Your pop and your uncle probably know about this type stuff. But let's see what you got, bro.
Damn. You ain't picture this, nigga. Pin game, it's all in the wrist, nigga. Think about that body bag before you diss, nigga. I'm a starter, I ain't worried about a bench, nigga. No more phones pinned back to the pad. They got me grabbing my duffel, now I'm back in my bag. We was handling business, now we back in the lab. I know the hook on NS1 cause he can't fuck with the jab. Struck him to snooze, they was overlooking the moves. Listen gears, they were full, they was putting my shoes. Got on my Prescott, then a man is so poised. Kids gon' tell it all, but a man gon' let it show, boys. Let me just say, heck how you feel. Uncle's acting like Phil, niggas fake. Always acting like real, got no rat so I pill. Loud as shit, all this pack in my seal. All these rules, I suggest you to chill. Your score under my score, that's the bottom of my line. You need lines just to follow my rhyme. I put the sight in the hind, bucking just to lighten my line. They got me fighting with bind, I mix my light on my line. Traders get autographs, the writing the slime. They think I'm outta, but I'm writing my time. I keep it 150 plus 150, that's a Spartan. My niggas parting, don't need none of them with me. I'm a lyrical killer rapper, please don't tell them come get me. Believe it not, you could tell them I'm Ripley. Couldn't lay off fit, me and Didak on some play off shit. Every night, no day off shit, they ain't gon' spray off shit. Y'all ain't shooters, y'all just say y'all shit.
Yo, you did it, bro. I liked it. You killed that, bro. Yo, when you said the 150 plus the 150, that's what.
Yeah.
I was like, okay. Okay,
yeah.
The 150 plus the 150. That's how we doing it.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's all right.
Yeah, so tell the people how they can get in contact with you. Tell them what you got coming up next and when you get married, bro.
Oh man, I can't say that because then she'll know. But because then she'll know. But definitely, man, you can catch me on any social media, any platform. My name is same on everything. Literally, it's JuannyMackk. Juanny Mackk, you can find me on anything. Like I'm on all streaming services, Apple Music, Tidal, you name it, I'm on it.
You on everything?
I'm saying on all social medias, I'm on all of that. And I got a project that I'm definitely about to drop very soon. Haven't came with a date yet. I'm still waiting for my engineer to finish up all the tracks.
Okay.
And I'm getting with a director. A director, choreographer for the videos, because it's gonna be a 5-song project called Genuine Love.
And it's going to be 5 videos.
Yeah, it's going to be 5 videos, and I'm trying to do all 5 videos together like a mini movie.
That's hot, bro. Well, it's your boy DJ Bugsy. We got DJ Amir coming up next. This is episode 81, man. Keep it hip-hop. Peace.